awareness for this one?
That awareness is Sajjanananda's awareness. Sat, Achit is awareness.
Normally, when we use this word awareness, like I'm aware of that or I'm aware of something in normal conversation. So it's something that is in the body, the mind, right?
No, that's the Jidabhasa. The reflection of that is Jidabhasa. The original awareness, Chitta, becomes Chidabhasa, reflective consciousness in you. I have already taken Chidabhasa class for you, no?
So the awareness that I am talking about is that Chidabhasa.
Chidabhasa.
Reflection. So, but what exactly is that? I am unable to differentiate between this, the attention that I understood, like the last class. But how can I identify?
No, Chidabhasa is the awareness which has manifested in your body.
Then that is consciousness only, right?
The consciousness and awareness, they mean same thing. Yeah, but consciousness, the word, many times consciousness is used with reference to body. Okay? Awareness is pure. It's just awareness doesn't know anything. Awareness is like a light. Okay? Chidabhasa, consciousness is a beam of light. You are able to see the object. Objects appear in that. Whereas, the awareness is the power which creates the Chidabhasa. It's like a sun which is reflected in a mirror.
But when we use the word awareness is everywhere.
No, that's actually, see, we'll find out that. I'll take that question, okay? So that requires a little bit of understanding. Atma Jyoti Prakriya for you? The Atma Jyoti? What is the light of self I have done, told you to people? Huh? Antar Jyoti, Bahir Jyoti, Pratyek Jyoti, Jyotish, Jyotisham Jyoti, is that the, I'll have to teach you that, then we'll understand.
So I have one question. In the physical world, it's only through reflected consciousness.
Okay.
So the mind, whatever, is all reflected consciousness.
Reflected consciousness is, okay. To make reflect conscious also is little bit tricky for you people, actually. I'll make it simple. Okay, you are sleeping in a bed. You had a dream. In that dream, you became a dream girl called Cinderella, who went to Paris. Okay. Now, dream girl took your identity. She says, "I am you." Manu is sleeping. Now she started roaming around in your Visa card and MasterCard. Spent your money. Okay. So now this dream girl Cinderella, does she know you?
No.
Do you know the sleeping girl known about the dream girl? You don't know. You are happily sleeping and she is happily spending your money. Right? Understand? That is the relation between you and Brahman. So Brahman is equivalent of sleeping you. Jiva is like a dream girl called Cinderella. Now the Jiva has a consciousness. Now that consciousness I call it reflective consciousness. It's not original consciousness of Jiva. It is borrowed from sleeping one. Okay? But the borrowed consciousness doesn't know about this. It is merely enjoying. Right? And that's exactly the relation between Brahman and you. The pure awareness is like a sleeping consciousness. It doesn't know anything. No world, nothing is known because nothing to know there for. Okay? And the world is Jiva, which is a dream character. That's why it's called Maya. Maya is a dream. In that dream, you have forgotten that original consciousness and you are roaming all around, but you have a consciousness. This consciousness is not yours. It is borrowed from Brahman. That's why it's called reflective consciousness. It's called Chidabhasa in Vedanta. Okay? Because Chidabhasa word also confuses. The example if I give, you understand. In dream, you have a borrowed consciousness. This is not yours. You are also not real. So this borrowed consciousness from sleeping person is called Chidabhasa. So from Brahman you borrowed consciousness and you are merely roaming around in the world. Okay, Brahman doesn't know the world. Brahman has no knowledge of the world. Awareness has no knowledge of anything. Awareness is pure. It's knowing ability, but it has nothing to know. You understand? I have knowing ability, but I don't have anything to know. Because there's nothing other than me in Brahman. Okay? But in the dream of Brahman, Maya, the world is created, then I have nothing, something to know. For something to know, Brahman has to take the form of Jiva to explore. Understand? That's the relationship. And one who explores is Brahman only, not you. Most of the people curse. Why that Brahman is dreaming and Maya, he has created me and made me to suffer. Okay? Actually, it is the Brahman who is going through you. It is not you. Whatever you consider as you is not you.
So if that's the case,
huh,
in the sleeping, whatever knowledge I have, I will not know the real I.
You will never know real I. Okay.
So knowledge in ignorance is of no use, you sir.
No, that's the point there. The point is, in the dream, Shravan Kumar's dream, Shravan Kumar went to Paris. Sleeping, he doesn't know the dreaming character. Right? The dreaming character went and spent money in your credit card. Now, if you ask that sleeping guy, what will he say? Who are you? He say, I am Shravan Kumar. He has borrowed your identity. He has borrowed your credit card. Right? He has borrowed his relationship also. He says, my wife is in Bangalore also. So, he has borrowed everything from you. And he remembers that he is you. Okay? And he gets into trouble. Right? The wife starts over shouting on the phone, why the hell you have not come back? Then he needs a Vedanta teaching, you are not you. Okay?
Yes.
So now the teaching is for Jiva, who is ignorantly thinking he is somebody who is real.
But does he ever know that?
He knows. That's the whole point of teaching.
That's
the whole point of teaching.
How knowledge in a dream can help
the dreamer
to know that he is a dreamer?
This is what the point is. The dreamer has a partial knowledge. He doesn't have full
knowledge.
Even if you ask that guy, he'll say, I am Shravan Kumar only. He don't know that I am Shravan Kumar only. That's why all the time he insists. 10 years back also I was there. Namaste, I won't change, doesn't change. He insists you are Brahman only in one hand. You have partial knowledge. You have out of three, Sat, Chit, Ananda. You have knowledge of Sat and Chit. That's why you say, I only. But your Ananda is missing. So we are only complimenting the missing part and reminding you this Ananda part. Okay? You have 2/3 knowledge, 1/3 knowledge is missing. For 1/3 knowledge, you are searching all over the world. Now, 1/3 knowledge is compensated, then you recognize that the one who is sleeping is me.
And how that infinity is known to a person?
It's not infinity, it's known. Infinity cannot be known. The point here is
he has to wake up.
No, please listen carefully. Brahman cannot be known at all. Brahman is infinity. Okay? The Vedanta cannot show you infinity. You understand? Because infinity cannot be recognized by the finite mind. Are you clear?
Correct.
But Brahman can be known as I am Brahman.
No, not perception.
Please understand. The perception will not satisfy the mind. Mind becomes peaceful. When you really recognize through Vedanta teaching, I am Brahman, the mind becomes very silent and peaceful. All your vidyate rade kranti chidyate sarva samshaya tasmin drishte paravar means, he doesn't see Brahman. He recognizes I am Brahman. I am the sleeping one who has taken the dream character, he will be recognized.
So after that, he is still in the dream or he has come out of
the dream? He can continue in the dream, but he knows I am Brahman operating in the world.
The dream doesn't end
in the sense for him the dream has ended, but for the world dream has not ended. Other characters will come to that.
There is no other character.
From his point of view, there is no other character. Now if you are asking the question, okay, from the point of view ignorant person, I will say for your dream has not ended, so you are seeing that person. Gnani.
This is from the Atmanis
point.
Character's point.
That's right.
Yeah.
So that's why I first started saying that a guru has disappeared. That's why people do Padaka Puja. Okay, from Guru's point of view, he has disappeared. But from Shishya's point of view, he is standing alone, eating food and talking.
So the point here is, Guruji, we are trying to... I can't use the word know also. Because whatever knowing is through the mind, you are trying to see that into the mind.
Jnana is for the mind only. Jnana is not for the Atma. Okay? Mana eva karanam manushyanam bandha mokshayo. Is mind different from Atma? Mind is also Atma. Because nothing is different from Atma. The mind is an Atma. Mind is nothing but Atma, consciousness, which has started conceptualizing and appearing separate. Now for that, you make it recognize that you are the original. Okay? So now that brings the peace to the guy because he is searching for his part in the world. Okay. So please understand, when you say knowing Brahman, you will not know Brahman as a mobile or as a laptop, or because infinity cannot be known by the finite mind. Knowing Brahman means recognizing I am Brahman. I am the sleeping one operating.
Can I say the dreamer recognizes himself as dreamer and therefore indirectly he knows?
No, he directly knows.
How?
That's what is.
Come back again there.
Okay,
how?
Let me.
Dreamer, let's example that. In that example, if I do not have the consciousness of infinity and through part negation of my part, how this part knows that there the infinity is
the part does a part. See, please understand, infinity cannot understand infinity.
Huh?
Brahman doesn't know Brahman.
Correct.
Okay, nobody knows Brahman, including Brahman.
Yeah,
because the moment that Brahman knows infinity, he becomes finite.
So what is the Vedanta?
But you have to understand the subtle logic here. Infinity cannot be recognized by anybody, including Jiva, including Brahman. Brahman doesn't know his existence because the moment he knows his existence, he becomes finite. Okay, that's what he will become. Okay, what is recognized is limitations are unreal is recognized.
So dreamer knows he is dreamer.
Dreamer knows this is all unreal.
Unreal.
Okay. Then in that unreality, he also, at the deepest level of mind, he knows that reality is infinity. Infinity, he doesn't know what is infinity. But he knows infinity as no limitation. Okay? It is a negation. So that is sufficient to make the mind still. Okay? So infinity cannot be recognized as a positively. It is not possible. Okay? Infinity can be recognized as absence of problem. So what is happiness? Absence of suffering. Infinity is absence of limitation. Okay, so I will take that question since that question is asked. Okay, so now the teaching is what? Okay, by knowing Veda, by knowing I am Brahman, what did I gain is the question. Okay, I gained infinity. I lost the finite. Okay, how is that? We'll understand. So let's first, I have actually given an exhaustive set of talks on this, okay? You can, there's some series of talks called Brahmanubhuti. About 40 talks I have given. Okay, you can go back and listen to that. The Brahman or infinity cannot know infinity. If infinity knows infinity, infinity is not infinity. It becomes finite. So Brahman is the ability to know, but has nothing to know. Including himself. Right? If you are everything, there is nothing to know. It's the end of knowledge, that's called Vedanta. Okay? Veda means knowledge. End of knowledge means Vedanta. Brahman has nothing to know, nobody to know, because he is everybody. When you are everybody, nothing is there to know. And nothing can be known. The moment you know something, you become finite. The moment Brahman tries to know something, he becomes you. He becomes Jiva. Because he has to become finite now. Okay? Then he looks back at himself. Then whole world appears. In the various perceptions. To look at the infinity, the infinite has to take the form of finite and look at the infinity in the form of the world. Right? The one infinity has to take a finite you and infinite world to experience. So this is not real because it's a dream of Brahman. Your dream is called dream, Brahman's dream is called Maya. Okay, that's why Narayana is many times shown as lying on the bed and dreaming. Okay, in his dream, the universe pops up, universe gets burst, everything happens in his dream. Okay, they happen, keeps happening. So the dream of Narayana is called Maya, and the dreamer is Narayana as Jiva. He has to see. There's nobody else now. It's only he only there. If there's somebody else, you can bring an actor. There's nobody else. So the consciousness itself takes the form of Jiva. Okay, it has to take from the jiva and the jagat. Okay, individual and universe, the same one consciousness takes. It takes the finite form to look at the infinity. The infinity, what you look at, becomes the world. Okay. So now you are dreaming, the sleeping Narayana, this jiva has a concept. He says he's God, he's created the world. So jiva, jagat, Ishvara is coming to picture here now. This guy has a concept now. Infinity, the world I am seeing is Vishnu only. Vishwam, Vishnu, Vashatkar, Bhuta, Bhayavro. The universe is Vishnu. The jiva is observing is Ishvara, Vishnu appearing in the form of jiva. He's looking at the world. Okay. Now the jiva has to remember, that's called Ishvara. Oh, Vishnu, I have to go back. Namaskara. So that's Ishvara. Jiva, Jagat, Ishvara is manifested now. Okay. So the jiva has taken three limitations. Desha, Kala, Karma. There are three bandhas. Desha bandha, Kala bandha, Karma bandha. So jiva starts feeling the pressure of time. Okay. So much of every day you are running around time. The moment there is a three bandhas, limitations. I am time limited, no? Before dying, I have to have a bucket list. You know, this is a bucket list, you heard this concept? Uh-huh. Huh? What is a bucket list? I know yours, Iceland. Do you have any bucket list?
Yes.
What is that?
Friends, visiting places, making things.
Becoming Brahman is not one of them.
Burning up the bucket.
Bucket is gone.
Desire only.
See, bucket list means people have a list of things. Okay. Okay? Before I die,
so
I have to do five things. Right?
That's all.
Huh?
Okay.
I don't know. So each of you have must have a bucket list now. Huh?
Yes.
You have. What is yours?
Ladakh.
Huh? Ladakh.
Ladakh.
That's simple. Marriage is not in the list. Huh? That should be important. Honeymoon came in Ladakh.
I bought a bike to Ladakh.
Biking to Ladakh. Okay, you can go pillion rider. Okay. So there are some list of things I need to do before I die. Because my life is time limited. It's a short span of time I have got. Right? Before you realize the time passes, right? So that desire will come. Because by fulfilling the desire, I feel happy, complete. That means you are already taken, that you are incomplete. The desire is required to fulfill you. So whole of your life you keep on chasing desires. Right? Now one desire will lead to another desire. It will not end. Okay? It keeps on adding. Going to Ladakh is one thing. Then after going to Ladakh, somebody said Switzerland is much better. Okay, in Ladakh they said, Ladakh is nice, but I have gone to Switzerland, it looks much nicer. Then your bucket list gets added, Switzerland. So it never ends, the list never ends. One after the other desire will arise. And by the time your body gets over, the desire is not fulfilled, you create another body to fulfill this. This is what is called karma. And also, this is a play, this is a creation, okay? This is a maya. In any play, there are specific set of rules. Otherwise, the play is not a play. The game is not a game. If you play cricket, there's a set of rules. Who created the rules? Somebody came and created it. The players created the rule. This is how? So, in Narayana, Brahman created a set of rules for this play. Which rules he will not violate. Otherwise, there's no fun in play, no? So, the rule is called karma. Okay, it's a set of game rules. If I do something, I have a penalty point, I'll get it back. Okay, that's called karma. Now, then, the right way to play game rule is called dharma. Okay, dharma and karma are rules created for playing this game. That's why it's called leela, play. Okay, but while playing, you get so involved. Now you have to see today India-Pakistan match.
Yes.
Blood will be, blood pressure boiling.
Exactly.
The game becomes so serious. Okay, right? Tomorrow morning, some news will be that some people, 10 people had a heart attack.
Yeah, so often it happens.
Okay.
Football and cricket
right?
Matches.
So you get so involved. India-Pakistan match is going on. Okay. India lost. The person is watching cricket match and he gets a heart attack. You see, the Pakistani player got $5 million because they lost, win one. Indian players got $2 million, they lost the game. The TV fellow got 500 crores because advertisement and you got a heart attack. Why? You got involved in the game.
Yes.
Without understanding it's a game. Similarly, you are getting involved in the game of life. Very seriously getting involved. Okay, the limitations are taken by you now. The limitation of body, limitation of time. The moment you take limitation of body, you become limited by space. Space limitation comes. The moment you say you are the body, the moment you say you are the mind, time will come into picture because time is nothing but thought. I have given a very good article on time. How time is mind. Time is thought. The limitation of time comes, the limitation of space comes into picture. Then in the limited time and space, you have a limited overmatch, right? That's called karma. Okay? You keep playing that. And you get limited by karma, time and space. Desha, kala, karma. So these three limitations, then you start feeling pressure. Okay? And what you are seeking happiness, which means you want to remove the limitation. Desha, kala and karma. That limitation you can never remove as long as you are playing the game. You have to at least you have understood that you are playing the game. Then you start becoming free. So the Vedanta teaching is to make you understand this is a game which is being played. Okay, you came here to enjoy the game. Now you are suffering because of the game. So understand your nature. Okay? You can continue to play till game ends, but understanding you have come to enjoy the game rather than suffer here is teaching of Vedanta. So now, the removing the desha, kala, karma, bandhana, okay, these are all conceptual, that's not real. So conceptual problem has to be removed conceptually, that's why teaching is there. Okay, I don't have to so many times to go into details. Many times I have given the talks on various topics. What is time? What is kala? So understanding conceptually starts, the grip of time, space and karma starts loosening on you. Okay, that loosening, you don't have to find infinity. The moment finite starts losing, you start losing, you start feeling relaxed. Okay, that is Jivanmukti. Losing the finite is Jivanmukti, not gaining the infinite.
Losing the ignorance is knowledge, not gaining something else.
Gaining something else. You understand? So this is what happened. Right? You have to loosen the ignorance. That's why the moment ignorance, avidya is removed, you are Brahman only. You don't have to realize God again. You don't have to remove Maya from the God. Let God have Maya. You get out of your ignorance subject. This is the teaching.
Because of this only they said Shankara is a Mayavada.
No, that's because the person who is speaking of that, he is talking from duality point of view. And who is talking from duality point of view? He is addressing people who are deeply in duality. Who don't want to accept that I am God. Okay? See, my Sadhguru teaching, earlier days, one day I spoke about moksha. Somebody immediately question came. What is moksha means? Moksha doesn't mean that having no rebirth. Okay. I said yes, moksha means freedom from birth and life cycle. Immediately the person logged out from the group. I want to take a birth. Okay. I don't want to get a free one. He said, I want to enjoy life. Okay. I have not developed as much bhakti as the great saints. I want to take many births to develop as much bhakti as those saints, then I want to see God, I want to experience God, then only I'll get to get out. That's why I don't, moksha is not required. Maybe she logged out of the group.
So easy.
What I'm saying is, there are always people who have a deep sense of ingrained duality. For them, what is the teaching required is, okay, you have duality, you work as a servant of God. That's the teaching. Don't worry too much. Right? You are seeking that, get that. Then somebody says, no, I want to be very close to Bhagavan. Then Vishishtadvaita comes. You are close to Bhagavan, but you are not Bhagavan. Okay. Somebody says, enough of being me and I don't want to be me. That's not duality. I have already enough of enough headache already. Being me is a big problem. I want to be me. Okay. In other words, somebody wants to commit a spiritual suicide. Madhava Advaita is there. I don't want to be me. God only sufficient. So, merge with God. Okay, that is called Advaita. Okay. So, where do you want to be, people? I mean, I can give you all the three teachings. I can as good teaching in the Advaita as good as in the Vishishtadvaita. I can convince you any three viewpoints. I can give yogic viewpoints also. Okay. Dvaita is you are separate from God. Okay? But you are a servant of God. God has created you as human beings to serve Him. Vishishtadvaita means you are related to God. Okay, you cannot be God, but just like a finger is related, part of God. Okay. So this class is about dropping me. I don't want to be me. Okay? Only God is there. That realization is called Advaita. Me and God, there is no place for two. Right? We are comfortable, me and God. Take care of me. As long as somebody there to take care of me, I am very comfortable. People want that dependency. Okay? They are not comfortable, me being not there. So the God, Dvaita, Advaita means me and God, there is no place for two. There's only one. Okay. There's no two at all. The two was an illusion. This is the teaching of Vedanta. This is the teaching of almost all religions. The core teaching. But over a period of time, people have packed so much that core teaching is not available to people. Okay. So is this much clear?
Yes.
Shashidhar, any questions? Me is a problem, sir. By this time you have realized, right? Some 10 years of experience in marriage is good enough. One child, lot of wise wisdom has come. Two children, wow, you are ready for mukti. Okay, so now how do you get out of this ignorance, avidya? I said, remove avidya, you are God. Okay? Remove ignorance, you are God. You don't have to gain supernatural powers. You don't have to add something. Okay? You have to only remove superficial. Right? How do you remove superficial? Okay? You can remove superficial only with the understanding. Because problem is conceptual, problem is not.
Problem is conceptual, the solution is also removing that concept.
So problem is conceptual. I am the body is a concept. Right? How do you know you are a body? You tell me. You have to give me a reason you are a body. You prove that you are a body. Tell me. How do you prove you are a body?
Now we know
we don't. Now you know.
We know our body because...
No, you know you are a body because of the input from others. You are actually indirectly input you are getting. People are treating and discussing with you as a body. Okay, your experience of body is a sensation. Okay, but that's not, that doesn't make you body. Other people treat you as body. Other people interact with you as a body. Okay, right? So that solidifies your concept, I am a body. Okay. How do you know you are a body? Tell me. You are not body. And that's why the Vedantic teaching I started that avastha traya, right? Jagrati, Swapna, Sushupti. If you look at your own three experiences, waking state, dream state, deep sleep, you realize that you are not a body. You are something which is unchanging, which is behind the body. And that unchanging is Shiva, unchanging is you. Then if you again you cry, I am the body, then what to do? Adnana has to be removed only through Dnana. Okay? You understand? But Dnana has to be given in a very clear way where you can understand. Otherwise it won't become Dnana. It becomes another
concept.
Right? So Dnana has to be given in a way you can understand it, internalize it, and apply in your life. Right? So the person who is able to give that Jnana in an understandable way, in a way you can apply in your life, is called
Guru.
Okay? The contribution of the Guru is making you understand the truth which is not available to you in the day-to-day course of life. Right? In a way you can understand it and apply in your life. Such a person is only called Guru. If he tells something which you can't understand, then he is not your Guru. He may be Guru for somebody else. You understand? And if he tells, I have this experience, believe me, then he is not a Guru. This system doesn't work on the belief. This system works on your conviction, your clarity. Okay, so a person is a guru if he is able to make complex things simple for you to understand. Okay, a person is a guru who brings the heaven to the earth. Very complex things he makes it so simple, like Karatala Malaka. That Karatala Malaka is the word for that. That Amla, no? That Malika is. Amla in your hand, gooseberry. In your hand, you see it. Okay, like that, the truth has to be made accessible to you. Such a person is called Guru. Okay, his ability to make it accessible to you, he uses the techniques, teaching methodology. The teaching methodology is based on the examples, based on anecdotes. Based on what you can understand, and he teaches based on your experience, not his experience. Okay, the teaching has to be based on your experience, your day-to-day experience which you are going through, but he will make you understand what you have not noticed in your day-to-day experience. In day-to-day experience you'll notice something and you don't notice something, you ignore something. The ignoring part he brings to your attention, so you understand the ignored part of you. That's what avastatraya prakriya is. Avastatraya prakriya is not some supernatural truth. Waking state, dream state, deep sleep, all the things you are going through. Okay? You are living as if waking state is reality. The Guru only brings up, in these three states, there is something unchanging, that is you. So from your experience, he brings a reality. That's second characteristic of Guru. Are you clear? He doesn't say, oh, I had a supernatural vision, I saw something, you believe me, follow me. No. Somebody says, you follow me, you believe me, is not a Guru in Vedantic system. He has to make you understand the truths. And he has to make you show the truth based on your own experience. The third thing, this is called the ability to teach. Is okay? Ability to teach is required with the examples. Your own experience is required, not supernatural experience. That's why it's called Vedanta. It's called Anubhava Vedanta. It's based on experience. Now people start thinking that Anubhava Vedanta means I'll start experiencing something new. Vedanta, Anubhava Vedanta. Anubhava means experience. Vedanta means end of knowledge. With the experience of what you have, your knowledge has to end. with not some of the new experience. Whatever experience you have is enough actually. Good and bad you have enough. You don't need any more experience. With that your knowledge has changed. That's called Anubhava Vedanta. Right? Not some special experience. Then you'll ask, what is the special experience? Some people have some special experience, some experience the same thing. That's good. But that's not universal. They are gifted, extraordinary. Respect them. We are looking only for what is applicable to Aam Aadmi. Ours is Aam Aadmi Party. Common man. Okay? Every common will, I'm going to day-to-day experience. I don't have time to go to Himalayas. I don't have time to grow a beard because I am a woman. That's okay. Vedanta can be understood based on your own experience. You don't need any special experience. Okay? The third aspect of that is if somebody has to give the truth, he himself should be established in the truth. Okay? Others, what will happen? There will be inconsistency in what he teaches. There will be always a gap in what he teaches. Then that gap will lead you to confusion, distortion. Somewhere some words and this thing will cause confusion in you. So his understanding, his realization and his communication has to be in tune. That gives the perfect understanding. A person who is established in truth is called Brahmanishta. And person who is able to communicate that is called Shrotriya. It doesn't mean that he will quote scriptures. Okay, don't some Sanskrit grammar and all. No. Shrotriyam, Brahmanishtam. He should be established in truth. If he has a half mind, I am a human body or mind or I am suffering, then he cannot give a convincing clarity. Okay, there should not be any split in his being. Then the talk and inner stand, they become one. That's called Brahmanishta. Shrotriya means he is able to communicate. Don't be under the impression that he will communicate quote some slokas, quote some Upanishad and all. But whatever he quotes, whatever he talks, becomes Upanishad. Okay, Ramakrishna Brahma, so whatever he talked becomes Ramakrishna Upanishad. So such a person is required as a master. Such a person is called Sadguru, a realized master. Now there are many Sadgurus in the world. Okay? Right? But easy for me. For every girl, there are 100 boys who are looking for marriage. But easy for me. Okay? Right? So, if there is a match between you and the Sadguru, there are many people who are there. They're masters. Some of the chemistry and biology doesn't sync match. So if he becomes cause for wisdom in you, then becomes Karana Guru. Okay? He becomes the cause for the causeless in me. Atmadna is causeless. He becomes the Karana for me. Such a becomes Karana Guru. Sadguru is a realized master. He himself should be realized. There are many people who are realized. But they cannot be Karana Guru for me. Right? There should be some sync has to happen. Whatever sync happens to from the universe, that sync happens, then I get a clarity. I get a clarity and I come to understanding this is the truth. Okay? Then he is called Karana Guru. Okay? Until that point of time, your search will go on. Until the deep condition says this is the truth, the search will go on. Right? There are millions of Sadgurus, there are millions of realized people. Are they for me? Okay. Finally, we settle down. This is the person, or this is the master from whom I can get the wisdom. That person is called Karana Guru. Okay. So this match happens, then ignorance will go. Ignorance will go. How does it go? Shravana Matrena. The truth can be understood only by listening. Okay? The Atmadnana can happen only Shravana Matra. Because ignorance is because of understanding. Right understanding will remove the ignorance. That's called Atmadnana. Then you will ask the question, why I am an idiot like this only? Before hearing also. Shravana Matra is over. I am convinced this is the truth. And Guruji is convinced the truth. I am also convinced the truth. But why I am like this? Now the question comes, who is that I? The eye to eye, real eye switch over has not happened. Okay? Why? Why it has not happened? Because you have been given a very, very powerful engine called mind. Very powerful engine. It's called subconscious mind. It is a very useful servant. Very useful servant. Wonderful servant. For example, you learned driving. Right? You started driving. Very consciously you have to drive. After driving for some couple of times and meeting with the accident one or two times. Okay? Now you are driving, becomes perfect. Then when you are driving, you can look somewhere, listen to that the music, okay, think of your office, you are driving, you'll go on. Correct? Now what happened to you? Your driving is taken over by autopilot. Okay? The autopilot is called subconscious mind. It's a perfect servant. Okay? But you have taught many wrong things to the servant. It is following perfectly well.
Perfectly wrong.
Okay? The first few great things you have taught that servant is, I am the body. I am the mind. I am the intellect. You have taught it so well, and you have told him to respond to that situation based on, I am the body, I am the mind, I am the intellect. Now you are not responding. That guy is responding. You understand what I am saying?
Conscious mind is not responding.
You are responding now. Okay, the moment you say you are a donkey, you start behaving like a donkey. Then that person will irritate you further. You are going to Vedanta class for 10 years. Now you are still a donkey. Then this guy is getting split now. Oh, I am going to Vedanta class. Huh? I have understood the truth so well. It's all intellectual knowledge. What happened to me? Intellectual knowledge, what happened to me? You understand? So now, this guy has a doubt now. Have I understood? Have I not realized? Then you bring a concept. Intellectual knowledge is understanding. Realization means something else. Some experience is required. Do you understand what I am saying? The autopilot concept you heard? Say, the understanding is realization is same. There is nothing called realization and understanding different. If you get a clarity, this is the truth. I am Brahman. Okay? That is called understanding. That is called realization. Finished. Matter is over. Now you start looking for, oh, I have understood, but I am like this only. Right? Why you are like that? Because you have a very powerful subconscious mind, which is very good servant. Okay, very useful for teaching it so many automated, regular routine tasks. Like for example, cooking you do. In the beginning when you cooking do, you need to know exactly how much salt you have to put. Okay, if a little bit more or less it will be. Now after 5 years of cooking, you don't even look at the salt jar also. Exactly. Who is doing this now? You are not doing it. Subconscious mind is doing it. It's taken over. So most of your conscious activity, subconscious mind takes. So it's offloaded to the servant. You are the conscious mind now. Now, Dana, you have got conscious mind, you have got properly, you understood properly. Still there is a gap. I need to get some experience. I need to get some experience. That's all is the experience. Now you, somewhere I'm missing, something is missing. No, that Guruji looks so smart actually. With his closed, half-closed eyes, he looks so nice. And I can see some light coming from his head. My light, no, nothing is coming, only white hairs are coming. You always think there's a gap. Something, hair is also going, but nothing is coming. So, there is a gap. We feel always there is a gap in my understanding and experience. Understanding is experience. Okay? Understanding is relation. Jnana is not a means to an end. That means I have to do something for ending. Jnana is end to all means. It's the end. The end. That's all. No scripture, nothing will teach you more than what I have taught in this one class. Over. Then you say, no, still I am like this. Now, who is that I? This is the subconscious mind. It is programmed all your life to behave in a certain way. Okay? It's well programmed. Right? Its basic starting program is what? What's your name? Lakshmi. That is the basic program starts in that. Okay? And you are a girl. So the program is started very early in life. So you are a beautiful girl. And all good girls should behave well. All good girls should not laugh in front of others. So all behavioral programming has been done. To whom? To the subconscious mind. Now when you are interacting, you are living your life. Your mind is living a life. You are not living the life. Okay, dhana is this much only. Atmadhana is this much only. Then you will ask, what did Buddha do after 60 years? What did Ramakrishna Paramahansa do? They must be something special. All of them understood this much only. But they were able to reprogram the subconscious mind to some extent. Okay, that is not new, this thing. That's only with the dhana you are correcting your habits. That correcting the habits based dhana is called nididhyasa. Okay, realization is shravana matrena, over, finished. There's no more realization. But some correction can be done for your subconscious mind programming which has gone so far in life. That's called nididhyasa. So what do you do? Nididhyasa means you sit. I am Brahman. The mind will come and say, hey, you only told I am a nice girl. I am a girl only. I am a mother only. So mind will come back with objections. So now, normally, you would have got dragged into the thoughts. If you don't have dhana. Right? That's called self-talk. All your suffering in life is not because of the situation, but because of self-talk. Right?
Not because your husband is talking.
Not because of husband talking. What you think of husband talking is the problem. You are not able to... I wish you, Shravan, you are able to look back and see what is the response is coming. You are facing me. Just wait for it.
This is only conscious mind.
Conscious mind.
Subconscious mind is behind.
So, what's happening? You are actually subconsciously programmed. The mind will come back with objection. Realization means something else. Something is missing in me. Because already you have put deeply that I am the body, I am the mind, I am the intellect. Conviction has happened at the conscious level and knowledge level. That's the right thing to happen and that's all it is. Now, this mind has to take control of that guy. You should reteach it. Okay? Teach it that I am the Atma. You sit for meditation, thoughts will come. So, you tell, I am consciousness, I am Brahman. So earlier you used to do self-talk. You used to get carried away by the thought, talks of the subconscious mind. Now, let teaching of the Guru, the Vedanta Vakya, give the reply back, not you. Understand? Self-talk has to replace by the teaching of Vedanta.
That is meditation.
That is called nididhyasa. Okay? Nididhyasa means not sitting silently. Nididhyasa means you have to tell your mind this is the truth. Now the dialogue is happening between whom? Your subconscious mind and conscious mind. Earlier subconscious mind was talking to subconscious mind.
So Guruji, the subconscious is also the impression from the past life as well, not just...
Don't bring the past life because the past life is also unreal.
Unreal. Okay. So, as you said, the divine child, that means when we are born, we are clear of all this chitta?
No, I am saying these are all concepts of past life, future life, all those things are brought in for a person who is being, for a person who is stuck in Maya. Now you have to understand the time itself is unreal. Then what is the past life? Yeah. Right? All that I am saying is some wrong understanding is coming from the subconscious mind. You have to correct it. So forget the past life, forget the future life, forget birth, forget death. Now if you are going past life, future life, birth and death, then again you are going back from
time
point of view.
Yeah.
Right? So you have to give a clear answer based on the teaching of Vedanta. And that teaching gradually, subconscious mind, I am the body, I am the mind, I am the intellect, will be replaced by I am Brahman. Okay, it's not a realization. Realization has already happened. It's a correction which is happening. Understand? There's the difference between realization and correction. Realization can happen only by hearing. And that too, hearing clearly, understood clearly, that's all over. So you start thinking realization is something else? No. The correction happens by Nididhyasa. Are you clear? The difference between reaction and correction. Because your vasanas, you react. The reaction mechanism you have to correct. You have to relearn. Okay? Otherwise, my dear, realization means this much only.
Why manana then?
Manana, Shravana and manana happen together. When the teaching happens in a very, very systematic way, Shravana and manana happens. Actually, manana difference is there, slight difference is there. Shravana means listening. Okay, yes, his name is Shravan Kumar, okay? He's good in listening. See how people keep their names, huh? He is good in listening, that's why Shravan Kumar. Okay, so Shravana means listening carefully what Guru is teaching. And Guru will teach in a way it touches your system. Brings a lot of clarity so that all doubts will vanish. That's all is called revelation. Vidyate rade kriti chidyate sarva samshayaha tasmin drishte paravare. Vidyate means the knot is broken. What knot is this? I am the body, I am the mind, I am the intellect is wrong. That's gone. Sarva samshaya vidyate rade means chidyate sarva samshaya. All doubts will vanish. What doubt will vanish? Yeah, what happened in, what was I in past life? The past life question itself is illusion. Doubts will vanish means the questions are invalid. Okay? When you are Atma, where is the past life for you? Right? Okay? So that's why one monk called Bodhidharma went to China. Bodhidharma went to China. He took Buddhism to China, very popularized. So he went to king. Buddhism already had reached China and the king had done a lot of service to the society. He had constructed a lot of stupas, temples, he kind of Buddhist meditation centers. The king asked Bodhidharma, Master, can I get Nirvana? I have constructed 500 stupas for Buddhist monks. I am feeding 10,000 monks every day. Will I get Nirvana? Bodhidharma said, laugh. No. Because your karma cannot lead to mukti. It can help you to purify the mind, but karma is not way to get mukti. If you do a million times some chanting, that doesn't lead to mukti. It will help you to focus on your mind. It will help you to purify your mind. That doesn't mean that puja or chanting is not... Chanting, puja or yoga will help. They will help you to chitta shuddhi or help your mind. Okay. Then he said, surely some karma is helping because Buddha did karma for 500 lifetimes in his Jataka tale. Buddha did karma for 500 lifetimes. I have read every Jataka tale. Okay. 500 lives he did good karma and that's why he became Buddha. Then Bodhidharma laughed. And he said, Buddha was dreaming a long dream. So all your past lives, all your birth and death, everything is a dream. Now your questions will become invalid because you are asking a dream question. In a dream question, if I have to give an answer, she asked a question, what happened to my past life for vasanas? If I have to give an answer in dream, I will say, yeah, vasanas will happen when your birth take birth also. Okay, there will be seed vasanas, some good karma will come, I will say. But I don't want to say it. I say that vasana is irrelevant. That questions will become irrelevant. Chidyate sarva samshaya. Tasmin drishte paravare. The supreme is seen by him. Okay? That means you will not see Shiva. You will not see. Nobody can see Shiva. Shiva himself cannot see himself. The moment Shiva sees himself, becomes Jiva. The moment Brahman sees himself, he becomes Jiva. Because finite seeing cannot see the finite. Infinite. Infinite cannot see infinite. Infinite moment sees infinite, tries to see infinite, it becomes finite. Are you getting what I'm saying? The infinite cannot see the infinite. The moment infinite tries to see itself, it has to take a finite viewpoint. It becomes a jiva. And the remaining infinite infinite part becomes the world. You understand? So, tasmin drashte paravara means seeing the paravara means Brahman in himself. It doesn't mean seeing. It doesn't mean, it means knowing. I know Brahman is false, but I am Brahman is reality. I am infinite becomes very clear to him. The limitations of time, space and karma is false, he becomes clear. Mithya becomes clear to him. Then I am infinite becomes clear. Still he continues to operate as jiva, but now the understanding has changed completely. Is it clear? So that has to go to subconscious mind. Because so far the subconscious mind is running on an engine. Program. Are you clear? That program has to be corrected. That's the difference between you and a saint. You are also saint. With this nana, you are also saint. Understanding level is same. Realization level is also same. But behavior levels are different. The behavior is a set of programming which has happened in your subconscious mind. Are you clear? So the behavior has to be corrected by reprogramming. What is the reprogramming? I am Brahman. Sit. This guy will come and say, no, no, no. You are so and so, I know. Yeah, you are such an idiot, I know. So you come back and say, I am Brahman. That's all. Nididhyasa. Guard your wealth. Otherwise, you start thinking, oh, realization means something else has to happen. Then you are missing. Again, you are telling your subconscious mind, something else has to happen. Okay? That guy will keep on expanding it. He knows. It's a good opportunity for him. Yeah, what realization? Something more has to happen. Can you see? There's a light coming from that saint, aura. Show me one ray of light from your head. The objection will be raised. By whom? Where subconscious mind. Before jnana, okay, the objections will come from subconscious mind. Answer will also come from subconscious mind. You are talking to yourself, self-talk. Right? So now, the self part you remove and put Guru stock, install Guru in that. That's the meaning of installing Guru. The teaching of Guru has to reply back, not your self-talk. Right? So then what will happen? The mind will become peaceful. The Guru has to be installed in your heart means the Guru has to reply back to others. Your self-talk talking to this thing will be a problem. That's the whole purpose of satsanga. The teaching you of a new way of thinking based on the Vedanta. If you continue in the same way of thinking, your self-talk will continue. I just want to give you an example, two examples, just to make you understand how people learn. These are all called so-called spiritual people. One of the persons, one of the ladies came to me. She is a doctorate in philosophy. She has done very amazing work on nirvana. Okay, liberation. And she says, she is a middle age plus. She came to me. She said, I am able to see Ramana Maharshi every day. Okay? Where? When I am standing for cooking, Ramana Maharshi will come. What you are cooking today? When I am going to office, in my car, he will sit with me. When I am teaching in the class, he will stand and watch. I said, great. Then he asked, why did you come here? Ramana Maharshi asked me to come here. Okay, that's also great. So then she asked me, what is that? Why Ramana Maharshi asked me to come? Please ask her. Then I asked from her, okay, Ramana Maharshi comes and stands you 24 hours. She says 24 hours. What did he tell? What does it teach? What does it tell you? He tells me what cooking I have to do. What?